Hello everyone, welcome to All Report. My name is Dinkar Porwar and I welcome you all in this new session, new interactive series of NABARD Grade A 2021 Top 25 Descriptive Question and Answer that we will be discussing in this series. Okay, so in every lecture we will be discussing 3 to 4 questions especially related to your NABARD mains examination. Okay, so as you all know that in the NABARD grade A examination, final mains examination, that is phase 2 examination, there you have a descriptive question of ESI ARD of 15 marks and 10 marks and having a word limit of 400 words and 600 words. So for that, we have come out with a new series where we will be discussing top 25 important descriptive question and answer especially for NABARD grade A 2021 phase 2 examination. And today is the first lecture on that series, and here we'll be discussing around four important questions for all of you. Okay, so please let me know how many people are there in the chat box. Just let me know by saying hi to me in the chat box so that we can start with our lecture right away. Okay, so may I know how many people are there? Okay, let me see. Anyway, hello Nilesh, hello, long time everybody. Yeah, it's a long time. After I think 2-3 weeks we are participating in a session. Okay, so this is a lecture 1 on ESI ARD descriptive answers. Okay, so here we have come out with a series. This is a part 1 and here we'll be discussing some of the question answers over here. Okay, you just have to sit there and just see what all you have to write whenever the questions are coming in the examination, because the word limit is about 15 marker. There's a word limit of 600 words. Okay, and for 10 marker you have a word limit of 400 words. So that's why we have to include all the points related to your answers over here. Okay, so based on that we have created a series. Okay, fine. So let's start with our session now. So the first question for today is, what is mulching? How mulching is beneficial for farmers to increase the profitability from their farms? Okay. Yes, Nilesh, we are there only. Okay. For ESI ARD, we are doing that. Okay. So you will be getting the question answers based on that. Okay. So whatever the olive board will provide to me, I'll just do that. Okay. So what is mulching? So here, first of all, you have to write what is mulching. Then how is mulching beneficial for farmer to increase the profitability of their farm? So there are two parts of the question. So first of all, you have to give the definition of mulching. Mulching is an agronomics measures in which a layer of crop residue or other material like plastic is applied on the surface of the soil. If you might have seen that in the places, you might have seen that sometimes the crops are covered with the polythene or some crop residue like that. Okay, so this is the basic definition of mulching. Okay, now after that, what types of mulches, like what are the type of mulches that we are providing? First is organic mulch. Organic mulch, that means we are deriving it organically, right? Organic mulch is derived from the plants and animals that they decay easily. Okay, straw, sawdust, dried leaves, animal manures that are used as organic mulches. Okay, so these organic mulches are efficient in reduction in the nitrate leaching, improve the soil physical properties and also prevent the erosion and also regulate soil temperature and also helps in the water retention. So this is the organic mulch. Okay, then we have a inorganic mulch. So it is that which is prepared in the laboratories. So inorganic mulches are the plastic mulches like PVC, polyvinyl chloride, polythene mulches, they are generally used. So type of plastic mulches which is being currently used in India farming are, so what are the type of plastic mulches that are in India where that we are using is, okay. Okay, so one first one is the black mulch. Okay, so here what we have to do is we retard the weed growth completely and doesn't allow the sunlight to pass onto the soil. Okay, so here we cover with soil in such a way that the sunlight doesn't reaches to the plant, so that the weed growth should not take place. Okay, because since the sunlight will not reaches to the wheat plants, okay, so it will reduce the process of photosynthesis. So okay, so it also help in conservation of the moisture, and it will also regulate the soil temperature. It keeps the crop cool during the high temperature. Okay, then the second type of mulch is the clear or the transparent mulch, okay, where you can see what is going on inside the soil. So here this has been used to reduce the infestation of the soil pathogens and nematodes to a great extent, and it helps the soil warms and hind widely used in the hilly areas. So this is mainly used in the hilly areas. Okay, so then C is the two-sided color mulch. So there will be two different color sided mulches are there. One side will be of different color, other side will be of different color. So so it will be like yellow black, which is used to trap the insects, white and black to keep the soil cool, silver or black color, it helps in repels the aphids, that is aphids are a small sucking insects, and or red or black, where that helps in partially cooling of the soil. Okay, so by proper selection of plastic mulches composition, color and thickness, it is possible to precisely control the soil environment. Okay, so now what are the effects of mulching? So after doing this process of mulching, what are the effects? So it helps improve the soil temperature through evaporative cooling, radiation shielding and heat conduction. It helps in the soil nutrition, retention of the soil nutrition, proper soil structure formation and proper retention of the organic matter, and it improves the availability of the water by controlling the runoff, increasing the infiltration and also help in decreasing the evaporation so that it reduces the weeds. Okay, so now the second part of the question is how mulching helps farmer in increasing their profit. Okay, so farmer can increase their profitability if they adopt the practice of mulching in their field, because it helps in conserve water, it helps control the soil erosion. Okay, so because if you are able to control the soil erosion, if you are able to conserve the water, automatically you will get the benefit out of it, right? So whenever the soil is covered with organic mulch, it helps to prevent the weed growth. So there will be a prevention in the weed growth. It helps in increasing the infiltration of the rainwater during the growing season. And it also decreases the evaporative loss that is applied to the water to the crops. Okay, now this plastic mulches also help in shedding the excessive water away from the root zone during the excessive rainfall. Okay, so this plastic mulch, whenever we are providing the plastic mulches, it prevent the excessive water to be retaining there over there. Okay, so it just the excess water will be removed from that place. Okay, hence the irrigation frequency get reduced, so you don't have to irrigate the field again and again, because the mulches help in keeping the soil moisture under the control. Mulches also reduces the fertilizer loss. Okay, so whatever the fertilizer that you have applied to the crop, it prevent that loss also, and because of the leaching. Okay, and it also helps in making the nutrition available during the soil. So it also help in reduction in the weed growth. Okay, sometimes we are using transparent polythene. We are using transparent polythene because we wanted to reduce the white fly population, and we wanted to control the aphid control, and thus we wanted to reduce the viral diseases so that the viral diseases to the crops can be controlled. Okay, so the mulching or also help in the uniform crop growth. So mulching also helps in the uniform crop growth and early harvest, thus giving the farmer the proper opportunity to sell their crops at the required rate if they are not in surplus. Okay, so like that. Now what is the conclusion you have to give regarding this? Okay, so conclusively, it can be pointed out that mulching protects soil surface. Okay, mulching protects the soil surface from getting eroded. It reduces the fertilizer cost by reducing the leaching cost and hence increasing the availability to the crops. Mulching also reduces the expenses that have been incurred on the labor cost, because here if we are applying too much of irrigation, then labor cost will be applied, too much of labors will be there, so we have to pay for the labors also. So in the mulching, it prevents the soil moisture and you don't have to frequently irrigate your field. Okay, इट इज द वर्क ऑफ द प्रॉपर मल्चिंग सो दैट इट रिटेन्स द मॉइस्चर ओवर देयर. ऑर्गेनिक मल्चिस एड्स ऑर्गेनिक मैटर टू द सॉइल अराउंड 3 to 5 टन पर हेक्टेयर. Hence, improve the soil structure. It will also directly have an impact on the roots growth. Okay, mulching also reduces the cost incurred upon the herbicide application. So we don't have to put too much of money in the herbicides, and we don't have to buy too much of herbicide. Okay, at present water scarcity. Everybody knows that there is a huge water scarcity that is going on, and it is causing a serious threat to the agriculture. Mulching is one of the very effective way to reduce the water consumption and effectively utilize the water in a proper manner. So in larger frame, many studies have proved to increase the benefit cost ratio. So there is a huge benefit cost ratio from farming if mulching practices are adopted by the farmers. Okay, so this is about the mulching. Everybody should know about it. Now we are moving to the next question. What is weed? Briefly explain the categories of weed control methods in our country. Okay, so what is weed? So here we have to define two things, and the second part we have to discuss in a very detailed manner. Okay, so what is a weed? A weed is an undesirable plant grown in the agriculture field. Everybody knows that whenever we grow something, undesirable plants also grow nearby that place, right? So that undesirable plants are called weeds. Okay, we are total, the collective name has been taken as weeds. So it is responsible for soil deterioration, and also it decreases the crop quality. So if weed grows near the plant, it takes the moisture from the soil, it takes the nutrition from the soil, so there will be less nutrition that is available for our crop. Okay, so that is why these are called weeds, and how we can control the weed in our country. So there are generally four methods for weed control: mechanical weed control, cultural weed control, biological weed control, integrated weed management. Okay, so we will be starting with the first one, that is mechanical weed control. So mechanical or physical method of weed control are being employed from the starting when the agriculture has started taking place. So it was the earliest method which we can think it of. Okay, so what kind of method they are utilizing? Are they are utilizing tillage, tilling the field, hoeing, hand weeding, digging, sickling, mowing, burning, flooding, or mulching? So these are the type. Here we can do the weed control through a mechanical methods. Okay, now, so what are the merits? What are the advantages of the mechanical weed controls? First of all, it is the oldest, effective, and economical method. So it doesn't require too much of money. Okay, here it can be done with the labors. Okay, only labor is required, and that can be done. Okay, it is the safe method for environment. It is also a safe method for the environment. It does not require any skills. Like, some skills are required, but it does not require very specific skills. Okay, so anybody can do that. Okay, so weeding is possible in between plants. Deep rooted weeds can be controlled effectively. Okay, so here deep rooted weeds can be controlled very effectively. But what are the demerits? What are the disadvantages? It is a labor consuming activity. It is a huge labor consuming activity. Okay, and there is a possibility of damaging the crop required ideal and optimum specific conditions. Sometimes it may damage the crop also if it is not done in a proper manner. Okay, so this is the mechanical weeding method. Now we have a cultural weed control. That is the second type of weed control that is happening in our country. Okay, so what is cultural weed control? Cultural weed control has several cultural practices like tillage, planting, fertilizer application, irrigation that are employed for creating a favorable condition for the crops. Okay, now what are the cultural weed control methods include? First of all, the cultural weed methods include summer tillage. During the summer time you can till your field. Then maintenance of the optimum plant population. Keep the plant population such that so that no weeds can grow. And then crop rotation, very, very good method to control the weeds. Keep on rotating your crops. Then growing of intercrop. So whenever there, if there is a gap between the two crops, you can just cultivate another crop over there. Then you can use the process of mulching, solarization. Then we have a still seed bed. Okay, so these are the cultural weed control methods. So what are the merits of the cultural weed control method? Cultural weed control method merits are: A, they are low cost. They are very low cost, easy to adopt. There is no residual problem. Okay. Technical skills are not required in this process, and there is no damage to the crop, and it provides a very effective weed control, and proper crop and weed ecosystem is also maintained. Okay, here we are not removing something completely, or here we are not accepting something completely. Okay, so here crop weed ecosystem is maintained properly. Okay, now what are the demerits? What are the demerits of that system? It immediate and quick weed control is not possible. So if you are thinking that you can immediately control the weed with this method, it is not possible. Immediate weed control is not possible. Okay, but here the weeds are kept under the suppressed condition. That means the weeds are still present, they are kept only under the suppressed condition. Okay, once you remove the barrier from them, it will again start growing, right? Then they are perennial and problematic weed cannot be controlled. So the perennial and problematic weeds, that means the weed that have taken too much of time, they cannot be controlled from there, and practically there is a little difficulty in adoption of this process. Okay, now we have the third method of weed control, that is biological method. Biological method are the use of living organism. Here we are using the living organism like insects, diseases, organism, herbivores, fishes, snails, or even competitive plants for the control of weeds in the biological control. Okay, so but this method is not useful to control all kinds of weed. Everybody knows that no method is complete for everything. Okay, some methods are good for some process, some method are good for some process. So here also the biological method can be only used for few crops. Okay, so introduced weeds are the best targets for the biological control. Okay, now so what are the merits of this biological method? The merits are that it creates very less harms to the environment. There is no residual effect. That means the proper, see, since we are using the biological method, it is all present in the nature. So that means there is no residual effect. It is relatively cheaper, and even the process is long lasting. Okay, so it will not affect the targeted plant and safer in during the demerits. Okay, so some of the demerits, I have to write it over here. Some of the demerits are: the multiplication is costlier. So if you wanted to do this in a very large area, then it is a costlier method. Okay, and the control is also very slow. And the main and major bottleneck over here is there are very few host specific bioagents that are available at present. That means there are very few host specific bioagents that are available for this biological method. Okay, now the fourth and the last one of the weed control method is integrated weed management. So what is there in the integrated weed management? So integrated weed management may be defined as the combination of two or more weed control methods. So here we are combining two or more methods together at low input level so that to reduce the weed competition in giving a cropping system below the economic threshold level. So why we are utilizing this integrated weed management? So one, why? Because we are using integrated, because one method can be effective for the one situation, but it may not be effective for the other situation. Okay, so we have to apply 2-3 method all together so that if anything, if any weed is got separated from one type of method, so other weed can be separated by the other kind of method. Okay, and even no single herbicides are effective in controlling the wide range of weed flora. Okay, so there is no single herbicide which can control every kind of weed flora. Okay, so that is why we have to apply integrated methods. Okay, and if we are using continuously the same kind of herbicides, okay, so it may create a resistance to that herbicide. The plant may gain the resistance regarding that herbicide, and maybe they may get that kind of quality that next time if you apply that kind of herbicide, it may not even act on them. Okay, so continuous use of only one practice may result in some undesirable effects. So you don't have to practice the same practice for long time. Okay, so you have to keep on rotating your practices. Okay, like example, rice and wheat cropping system, Phalaris minor. Phalaris minor is a type of a grass which is native to North Africa, Europe and South Africa. So because of that, this kind of weed grows between the rice and wheat cropping system. Okay, so only one method of weed control leads to the increase in the population of the particular weed. So if you are using only single kind of weed control method, it may lead to increase in the other kind of weed. Okay, and if you are utilizing herbicide indiscriminately, so it may affect the environment and also the human health. Everybody knows that right now we are facing a huge effects on the environment and human health because of the application of too much of chemicals over the plant surfaces. Okay, so what are the advantages of integrated weed management? So it shifts the crop weed competition in favor of the crop. So in the integrated weed management, the competition between the crop and weed will be going towards the crop. It prevents the weed to shift towards the perennial nature. So it will not make the weed go towards the perennial nature. Okay, it will not make that weed to be become a perennial. That means it becomes the all time weed for every time, right? So it is just a temporary one. Okay, it also help in the prevention of the resistance in the weed to the herbicide, and there is no danger of herbicide residue in the soil or plant, and there is no environmental pollution. It gives higher net returns. It helps in suitable for high cropping intensity, and it also protects the soil, and it also keeps the soil fertility as it is. Okay, now so these are the two questions that we have discussed right now regarding mulching and regarding the weed. Now the third question is regarding the mixed farming. Now the next question is regarding the mixed farming. What do you understand about by the mixed farming? What are the different ways of farming to maintain the ecological balance? What do you understand by mixed farming? So what is mixed farming? So mixed farming, it is a situation in which both raising crops and rearing animals are carried out simultaneously. So here you are raising the crop also, and at the same time you are rearing your animals at the same field, so that both things can utilize each other, like the cow dungs and all these things can be utilized by the crops, and the animals can eat the residual crops. Okay, so this is the definition of the mixed farming. It is a situation in which both raising crops and rearing of animals are carried out simultaneously. Okay, then so to maintain the ecological balance, so the next part of the question is, to maintain the ecological balance, sustainable farming is used. To maintain the ecological balance, sustainable farming is used. So what is sustainable farming that we will be knowing? So sustainable farming is a way, means to meeting society present food and textile need without compromising the ability of for the current or the future generation to meet their needs. So this is the basic definition of sustainability, right? To meet the present need without compromising the future needs. Okay, so it can be based on an understanding of the ecosystem services. Okay, so what are the method of sustainable agriculture? So there are few method of sustainable agriculture, like crop rotation, permaculture, crop cover, soil enrichment, national pest predator, bio intensive integrated pest management, polyculture farming, agroforestry. So these are the methods which are used for sustainable agriculture. Okay, we are not utilizing the too much of chemical fertilizer, and we are focusing on the organic way of cultivation. Okay, So, what are the benefits of sustainable agriculture? What are the benefits? It first of all, it helps in contribution to the environmental conservation. It prevents the pollution. It prevents air pollution. It prevents soil erosion. It also helps in the reduction in cost of cultivation, because most of the product you can derive naturally over here, right? So, what are the method of sustainable agriculture that we have discussed over here? So now we have a few detailed lines about that. Okay, crop rotation is the most powerful technique. Okay, here we are not planting the same crop each and every time. We are planting the single crop for a few years, then after that we are changing the crop cycle. Like if you are growing the wheat for 3-4 years, and for the next 3-4 year we can do some other type of nitrogenous crops like that. Okay, so its purpose is to avoid the consequences that come with the planting the same crops in the same soil for years in a row. Okay, first of all, it helps in tackle the pest problems. Okay, if the pests have a steady food supply, they can greatly increase in population. And rotation helps, the crop rotation breaks this reproduction cycle of the pest. Okay, so during rotation, a farmer can plant certain crops which also replenish the plant nutrition, and they also help in the reduction of the chemical fertilizers. Then the second method is permaculture. Permaculture is a food production system with intention, design and smart farming to reduce the wastage of soil and also create increased production efficiency. Permaculture design technique include growing grain without tillage. So, the main focus of this is the use of perennial crops such as fruit trees, nut trees and shrubs all together to function in a designed system that mimics how plants in the nature ecosystem would function. Okay, now the third thing is the crop cover crops. Many farmers chooses to have crop planted in the field at the time and never leave it barren. Okay, so some farmer never leave the crop in a barren field. Okay, they just keep some or the other cover over the field. Okay, so by planting the cover crops such as cover oats, farmer can achieve this goal of preventing the soil erosion. The main focus is to prevent the soil erosion, and it also enhances the quality of the soil. Okay, and the use of cover crop also reduces the need of chemical fertilizer. Okay, then the fourth way of doing is the soil enrichment is a central component of the agriculture ecosystem. How you can enrich your soil? Okay, so good soil can increase yield as well as help create more robust crops. It is possible to maintain and enhance the quality of this soil in many ways. So how you want it, how you can enhance and maintain the quality of the soil? Like first of all, we have to do the leaving the crop residue in the field after the harvest. Okay, so after harvesting of the crop, leave the crop residue on the field. That field, the residue will act like a fertilizer for the soil, for the soil enhancement. Okay, and we can also utilize the composted plant material and animal manure for in all this work. Okay, now what are the natural pest predators? What are the natural pest predators? So first of all, we have to control the pest population. It is possible to utilize the natural pest predators. Okay, in a view to for the farm of an ecosystem, for example, many birds, animals, they are the natural predator in agriculture pests. Okay, birds and animals can act as a natural predator. So managing your farm so that it can harbor population of these pest predators is effective as well as sophisticated technique. The use of chemical pesticides we can reduce by utilizing the natural pest predators. So we don't have to use the chemical for pesticides too much. We can utilize the natural pest predators. Then the sixth way is biointensive integrative pest management. So it is an approach which essentially relies on the biological as opposed to the chemical method. So integrated pest management emphasizes on the importance of the crop rotation. Crop rotation is very important if you really wanted to control the pest in your fields. Okay, so once you have identified your pest problems, we can utilize the proper chemical solution which can be used at least as a last resort. Okay, chemical solution can be only used at the last resort. Properly utilization of bio-intensive integrated pest management is a key. But if you are not able to control through a bio-intensive integrated pest management criteria, you can utilize your chemical solutions. Okay, fine. Now, what is polyculture farming? What is this polyculture farming? Polyculture farming is a technique that is similar to crop rotation. It is similar to crop rotation and it tries to mimic natural principle to achieve the best yields. The main aim is it involves growing multiple crop species in one area. So, it is not focusing on single crop. Here, they are focusing on the multiple crop species. They are focusing on multiple crop species. So, these species are normally complemented each other and help. So, it is not like that each and every species is competing with everybody. No. These species are chosen in such a way that they complement each other in their production. Okay. And it helps in the produce of the great diversity of the product at one plot while utilizing the available resources. Okay. So, high biodiversity makes system more resilient to weather fluctuation and it also prevents the balanced diet and applied natural mechanism for maintaining the soil fertility. Then the 8th one is what agroforestry. We can also do the agroforestry. Agroforestry has one of the most powerful tool of farmers in the dry region. Okay, in the dry region, this agroforestry is used with soil susceptible to the desertification. So, here what they are doing is they are growing trees and shrubs among the crop on the grazing land combining with the agriculture. Okay, wherever they are doing the agriculture, they are growing trees and shrubs over there. Okay, so trees and shrubs help in the prevention of desertification. It also help in reduction in the soil erosion. Okay, trees have another very important role. They can help in maintaining the favorable temperature. They stabilizes the soil. They properly protect the soil humidity. They minimize the nutritional runoff. Okay, and it protects the crop from very heavy wind and heavy rains. Okay, so these are the total 8 things which we have discussed regarding the mixed farming and what are the different ways of maintaining the ecological balance. So there are method of sustainable agriculture that we have discussed. These 8 methods we have discussed regarding that. Okay, now we are moving to the last question for today is what is tillage? Explain different type of tillage and their role in growing crops. So what is tillage and what explain the different type of tillage and their role in the growing crops? So tillage refers to the mechanical manipulation of the soil. So here we are doing manipulating the soil with tools and implement so as to create a favorable soil condition so that we can so that proper seed germination can take place and the proper crop growth can take place. Okay, so tilth is a physical condition of the soil resulting from the tillage. So tilth indicates two properties of the soil. So what properties of soil we wanted to control is size distribution of the aggregates and mellowness, like how soft the soil is. Okay, so who is called as the father of tillage? Jethro Tull is known as the father of tillage. Tillage is like we are cultivating the field, we are making the soil soft with the use of chemical tools and all those things. Okay, now how many types of tillage techniques are used? Tillage operation may be grouped under two categories. One, season tillage. Second one is off season tillage. Okay, one tillage. Aarti, we will be discussing the 25 important questions for your NABARD grade A examinations. Okay, here we will be discussing about 25 important questions today. Like we are focusing on the 4 question. Okay, so yeah, this session will be a regular one. Yes, this session will be a regular one. Okay, I hope you got your answers. Okay, so type of tillage. So there are, the tillage operation is grouped under two categories: off season, on season, and off season. Okay. Yes, Nilesh, these question can be asked in 10 markers or 15 markers. ओके सो दिस क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड इन 10 मार्कर्स और 15 मार्कर्स ओके बिकॉज दीज आर सम ऑफ द वेरी बेसिक क्वेश्चन ओके दैट इज व्हाई वी आर गिविंग यू ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग दिस क्वेश्चन आंसर दैट इज व्हाई वी आर गिविंग यू ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन ओके सी द आंसर इज वेरी लॉन्ग ओवर हियर ओके बट यू हैव टू सेलेक्ट हाउ मच यू हैव टू राइट ओके सो बेस्ड ऑन द क्वेश्चन वट एवर इज आस्क्ड इन द क्वेश्चन राइट ओनली दैट मच ओके सो types of tillage tillage operation may be grouped into on season tillage and off season tillage okay so what is on season tillage are done for raising crop in the same season at the onset of the crop season okay whenever the crop season start at the same time only we are doing the tillage of the field okay so there may be a preparatory cultivation and after cultivation okay so what is the preparatory tillage required so this refers to a tillage operation that is done to prepare the field for raising the crop here mainly we are preparing the field for raising the crops whatever the unwanted weeds are there unwanted stubbles are there we are removing at the preparatory tillage state okay then so what are the type of preparatory tillage first of all under the preparatory tillage there are two types one and two primary tillage and secondary tillage so what is this primary tillage so it is this type of tillage operation is done after the harvest of the crop to bring the land under cultivation that is known as primary tillage or it is also known as ploughing of the field ploughing of the field okay it is also known as ploughing of the field okay so what happens in the ploughing is the opening of the compact soil with the help of different ploughs okay here we are once the soil become tight after one harvest cycle we just wanted to make it smooth with the help of plough okay so country plough mold ball plough bose plough tractor we can utilize tractors also power tillers also we can utilize okay then after that we have a operation of secondary tillage okay so this operation happens on the soil after the primary tillage so as to bring the good soil known as secondary tillage okay so here it consists of lighter or finer operation mainly done to clean the soil break the colds and incorporate the manures and fertilizer inside the soil so here harrowing and planking is done to serve those purposes planking is done to crush the hard clods that is if the part of a soil is very hard so you can just do it by breaking that hard soil part and it helps the level the soil surface to the compact and it makes the soil lighter okay harrow cultivators guntakas and spades are used in the secondary tillage techniques okay now then after this all is done proper tillage is done soil has made been smooth okay then layout of the seed bed how the seed is done so this is also one of the component of the preparatory tillage so when we are doing the preparatory tillage we are laying the seed outlet also okay we are putting the seed also while we are doing the primary tillage okay so after cultivation what will happen is the tillage operation that are carried out in the standing crop after the sowing or plantation and prior to the harvesting of the crop is called after tillage okay so any tillage operation that has been carried out in the standing crop that means if the crop is standing and here they are you are doing some tillage operation on the crop that is called after tillage okay so this is also called intercultivation or post seeding planting cultivation because the crop is still standing at the same time you are doing the intertillage okay the main tools that are used over here is harrowing hoeing weeding earthing up drilling or side dressing fertilizer all these things we are using in the intertillages okay now that is just now we have discussed about the on season tillage we have discussed about the on season tillage till now this is done while the crop is still there and we are doing the operation during the season time only okay now we are coming to the off season tillage so what is off season tillage so off season tillage done for conditioning the soil suitability for the forthcoming main season so here we are doing this tillage technique before the season is coming before the season. Before the season starts, we are doing this operation. So, okay, off-season tillage may be post-harvest tillage, summer tillage, winter tillage, or fallow tillage. So, a special purpose tillage. Tillage operation intended to serve a special purpose are said to be special purpose tillage. So, this is the off-season. Then the third one is the special purpose tillage. A special purpose tillage is the type of tillage where we are operating on the soil based on the special purpose. Okay, this is different from off-season and on-season. Okay, so this is the special purpose tillage, which is only to serve the special purpose. So they are subsoiling. Subsoiling is mean to break the hard pen beneath the pluff layer. Okay, if the soil becomes very hard and we see that now we cannot just simply cultivate the crop, we cannot put the seed. So this is to break the hard pen beneath the pluff layer. A special tillage operation is performed to reduce the compaction. Okay, now, so what is the advantage of subsoiling? So what is the advantage of subsoiling is we can obtain the greater volume of soil for cultivation of crops, and if there is any excess water that is present, it may go downward, it may percolate downwards, and it can recharge the permanent water table. It also helps in reduction in the water runoff, helps in the prevention of soil erosion, and it will also help in the roots and the crop plants growth, and it also helps roots to penetrate deeper to extract the moisture from the water table. Okay, now we have another type of special tillage, that is called clean tillage. What is clean tillage? It refers to the working on the soil of the entire field in such a way that no living plants is left undisturbed. Okay, no living plants is left undisturbed. It is practiced mainly to control the weeds, soil borne pathogens, and pests. Okay, so here it is like here we are working on the soil in such a way that each and every plant, that no living plant is left undisturbed. Okay, it is like that. Then we have another type of tillage, that is called blind tillage. So it is done after the seeding or plantation of the crop, either at the pre-emergence stage of the crop plant or while they are at the early stage of the growth, so that the crop plant like potato, sugarcane do not get damaged like that. Okay, so this is called blind tillage. So mainly the blind tillage is done after the seeding of the plant. Okay, now there is another type of tillage, that is special type of tillage, that is called dry tillage. So what is this dry tillage? So mainly the dry tillage is practiced for the crop that are sown in the dry land condition. So there the dry tillage is used, condition having sufficient moisture for germination of the seed. So the main crops which can be grow, this is suitable for crops like rice, jute, wheat, oilseed, crop, pulses, and potatoes and vegetable crops. Okay, like that. Now, so dry tillage is done in the soil having a sufficient moisture of 21 to 23%. Okay, so that soil may become porous, okay, and soft due to the dry tillage. Okay, so it helps in the water holding capacity of the soil, and it also makes a more favorable condition for the microorganism. Okay, fine. Now we have another kind of special kind of tillage, that is called wet tillage. Wet tillage means here that operation is done on the land with standing water. That means here we are ploughing the field, here we are putting the field, we are filling the field full of water, and that place we are using that wet tillage technique. Okay, so here puddling techniques consist of ploughing repeatedly in the standing water until the soil becomes soft and muddy. Okay, so here what is done is we are ploughing the field so much as many times as we can so that the soil becomes soft and muddy. Okay, so this puddling creates an impervious layer below the surface to reduce the deep percolation and the loss of water, and it also provides the soil. So because of this continuous puddling operation, the water, it settles down at the lower level of the soil. Okay, so water do not goes just beyond the water table, so it just remain there, so that whenever plants need the water, it automatically just get from there. Okay, So wet tillage destroys the soil structure and the soil particle that are separated during the puddling settlers. So wet tillage is only means of land preparation for transplanting of the semi-aquatic crops. Mainly this wet tillage is used for transplanting semi-aquatic crops like rice. If you have seen the field of rice, if anybody has seen the field of rice, you can find it out that the rice field in the starting is filled with water, then only this tillage is done over that. Okay. Prakruti, just let me know in the comment section, once the lecture gets over, just let me know what guidance you need. Okay. You just write it in the comment box. Okay. After the session gets over. Okay. So planking after the wet tillage makes the soil level a compact, and puddling hastens the transplant operation and well establishment of the seedling. Wetland ploughs or worn out dry lands ploughs and normally used for the wet tillage. So these are the type of wetland ploughs, worn out dry land ploughs. These are used for the tillage operation in the semi-aquatic crops. Okay. Now, so modern concept of tillage. So what is this modern concept of tillage? So what is this model concept of tillage? So conservation tillage involves primary tillage to break open the and turn the soil, followed by secondary tillage. Okay. Then with the introduction of the herbicides, there is an intensive farming system. The concept of tillage has been changed. Okay. So now the concept of tillage has been changed. Okay. Conventional tillage, there is a to break open and the turn the soil, followed by the secondary tillage. Okay. Now we have a introduction of herbicides. Now we have herbicides. Okay. So now the concept of tillage has been changed. So we continuous use of the plough. If we are continuously using the plough, it creates a hard pen of the soil and it helps in the, and it makes the soil poor infiltration. It results in the poor infiltration of the water from the soil. And continuous use of ploughs also make the soil susceptible to the runoff and erosions. Okay. That is why we are utilizing the minimum tillage. The main aim of the minimum tillage is to reduce the tillage operation. We wanted to reduce the cost also. We also wanted to make sure that soil do not get hastened by this process, and we also don't want to destroy the soil structure, and we also want to retain the water, and water shortage can be taken place. Water shortage can be prevented in such a way that we cannot just go by simply the traditional tillage practices. We have to utilize the modern concept of tillage, so that we have to utilize the minimum resources and find out the maximum benefit out of it. Okay. Now, the minimum tillage system can be grouped. So there are minimum tillage systems. So what is this minimum tillage system? Is a row zone tillage, plow plant tillage, and wheel track tillage. Okay. So these are the three type of minimum tillage. So primary tillage is done with mold board plough, and the plow plant are a special planter is used for sowing. And in the wheel track tillage, here tractor is used for the sowing. Okay. Fine. So till now we have discussed about the tillage. Now what is zero tillage? What is zero tillage? That means we are not doing any kind of work with the soil. So in this, new crop is planted in a residue of a previous crop. Okay. Previous residue crop will be there. Upon that only a new crop will be planted. Okay. So zero tillage is applicable for soil with a coarse structure. So at which place the zero tillage can be applicable? It is applicable where the soil is a coarse textured surface horizon, where good internal drainage is there, high biological activity soil fauna are present. Okay. So normally these type of qualities are found in the alfish soils, oxy soils, and ulti soils type of soils, which are present in humid and some humid tropics areas. Okay. Now till planting. Till planting is the one method of practicing a zero tillage. A wide sweep and trash clear a strip over the previous crop row, and planter open a narrow strip into which seed are planted and covered. Okay. So there is a narrow strip which keeps on putting the seeds, and then open a narrow strip into which seed are planted. Okay. the herbicide function are extended before sowing. Before sowing the seed, the vegetation present over there has to be destroyed. Okay, so we have to utilize different type of herbicides. So what is the advantage of zero tillage? What is the advantage of zero tillage? Zero tillage soil are homogeneous in structure and they have a more number of earthworms. As you all know that earthworms are very good earth diggers. Okay, so also organic matter content increases due to the less mineralization. So in the zero tillage, if you are utilizing a zero tillage method, the organic matter content increases in the soil automatically. What are the disadvantages of the zero tillage? There will be a higher amount of nitrogen that has to be applied for mineralization of organic matter in the zero tillage. Then we have a perennial weed that can be a problem. That means the weed that can be present throughout the crop cycle. And there are a huge number of volunteer plants and there is a buildup of pest. Okay, so this is the advantage and disadvantage of the zero tillage. Okay, now, so now we have the other kind of tillage, that is stubble mulch tillage. Okay, I hope everybody, this answer is getting too much of longer, because there are too much things to discuss about the tillage and zero tillage and advantage of the tillage, what type of tillage is practiced where, or okay, so that is why the answer is getting little bit longer, but you can just go through this video again after some time. Okay, so there is a stubble mulch tillage or a stubble mulch farming. So what is this kind of farming? Here soil is protected all the time either by growing a crop or by leaving a crop residue. Okay, sweeps or blades are generally used to cut the soil up to 12 to 15 centimeter depth. Okay, when the large amount of residue are present, a disc type of implement is used to first operation on the soil. Okay, this hastens the decomposition but still keeps enough residue on the top soil. So two methods for sowing crops in the stubble mulch are there. Similar to the zero tillage method, there is a wide sweep and trash bar that are used to clear a strip and a narrow planter that will open a narrow furrow in which the seeds are planted. So a narrow chisel of 5 to 10 centimeter of width has been planted for all this purpose. Now, what is conservation tillage? What is conservation tillage? The major objective is to what is the major function of why we are doing this tillage and all those things is, the major objective is to conserve the soil and soil moisture. The main aim is to conserve the soil and soil moisture. Okay, so it is a system of tillage in which organic residue are not inverted into a soil such that they remain on the surface as a protective covering. So here the residue are not removed from the soil. They are kept there only so that it protects the soil upper layer. Okay, so if stubble form the protective cover, if stubble forms the protective cover of the surface, it is usually referred to as the stubble mulch tillage. Okay, so if any kind of stubble is used to as a protective cover on the surface, it is called stubble mulch tillage. Okay, so any residue left on the soil surface interfere with the seed bed preparation and sowing operation. So in a year-round system of managing plant residue, it may help implement the undercut residue, it loses the soil and kills the weed also. So what is the advantage of this stubble mulch tillage? First of all, it is a highly energy conservation through reducing the tillage operation. It improves the soil physical properties. It also reduces the water run off. So these are the special type of tillage operation. So first of all, I will just let you know to what is this. Tillage is of two types: on season tillage, off season tillage. And so on season tillage has a different preparatory strategies. Then we have a off season tillage. After that, we have a special purpose tillages that we have discussed till now, like clean tillage, blind tillage, dry tillage, wet tillage. Then modern. Then we have a zero tillage. Okay. Please understand this zero tillage properly. Okay, understand this zero tillage properly because it can be asked in your examination. Okay, then after that we have a till planting. Then after that we have a stubble mulch tillage or stubble mulch farming. So these are all the type of the tillage that we can do in our field based on the type of crops that we are growing, based on the type of region we are there living, and the type of soil present over there, okay, and type of climatic conditions over there. Okay, so these are the total four questions that we have discussed today. Tomorrow I have a two classes where tomorrow 25 questions for your ARD we will be discussing, and also we will be discussing five important questions related to your five question related to your ESI ARD MC current affair related questions. Okay, Prakriti, let me tell you that Prakriti, see, this is a time which we are making this kind of videos is because this is the first time I think that mains examination will be having the descriptive type of question and answers. Okay, so the major focus, you have to major focus on the important current affairs related to ESI ARD of the last 4 months. Focus on the last 4 months properly. Okay, for because we are expecting that by the from the last 4 months they are going to make your ESI ARDs a descriptive question and answers. Okay, and always have a proper word limit. Word limit is like, make sure that you do not cross the 600 word. First of all, you write any answer. Yeah, you write actually we are helping you. Actually we will be coming out with some of the related to horticulture, but right now we are only helping the peoples who are preparing for that general examination. Okay, so here horticulture, you have to see, for me, I am telling you what is the thing is, whatever important current affairs that are related to horticulture field, as you all know that government has come out with a various initiative regarding the horticulture field. Okay, there are many things which have been released, many schemes are there, everything are there which are related to horticulture. Just focus on the 4-5 months of the horticulture news, especially go to Press Information Bureau. There you can search the news. You can also go to my videos where I have discussed the current affairs. Okay, so it is the new for everyone. So just focus on horticulture related news for yourself. Okay, but just do not simply focus on horticulture. You have to do a very well balanced preparation strategy. Okay, do not completely go by single mindedly that everything, every question will be from the horticulture and you just leave other things all out. Okay, do not leave the things. Okay, but make sure that you cover all the 4-5 months of horticulture related news properly. You should cover all the property horticulture current affair news, because from there only they can ask the questions. Okay, yes, both static and current. You see, in the descriptive question I will tell you some of the important strategy what you can do. You should have a proper static knowledge about that. Current affairs related news about that. Okay, current affair related news about that, then some facts and figures if you know regarding. So proper facts and figures you should have, any reports that has been released by government. So in your descriptive answer you can utilize all these things. It increases the visibility of your answer. Yes, see, syllabus is more, but you are giving the exam for NABARD only, right? You have to do a selective study. Syllabus is there, based on the syllabus just check what is their current affairs that are there in your 5 to 6 months of news. Okay, check the syllabus, keep the syllabus handy. Always keep your syllabus handy. Okay, keep the syllabus handy. Check this topic is there in the syllabus, anything related to current affairs that has happened in the recent 4 or 5 months. Okay, so based on that, your preparation will come in a very coordinated and a directed manner. Okay, so check your syllabus, check the current affairs, and then match your current affairs with the syllabus, and based on that you have to prepare like that. Okay, see, yeah, if see syllabus is there, its syllabus is not only for you, it is for everybody. And first of all, let me tell you, always the exams are always relative. Exams are always relative. It is not like that you have to answer each and everything. Okay, if you are preparing well, if you are preparing well, and even after that you are not able to perform well, that means all, most of the people will be not able to perform well in that examination. The cutoff will come down, right? Okay, so exam is always relative. You don't have to worry about that, but you have to keep your preparation up to level, so that for you it is like, if you think that the paper has come tough, so the paper has come tough for everybody. Okay, so the cutoff will go down. So we are not asking you to read each and every word of the syllabus, okay, like that. Okay, just focus on the important things, okay, and do your preparation. I hope I have made my point very clear. Thank you so much. We'll be meeting you tomorrow. See you then. Take care. Bye-bye. Never forget to like, subscribe and follow. Happy learning. Thank you guys. Thank you so much. Thank you.